football. WROIFM.com.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. We are moments away from the kickoff of the first game of the regular season here at Rochester between Rochester, number 3, Eastbrook. Travis, as before we went on the air, we talked to head coach Mike Zahner. There are some kids not playing tonight. Let's talk about them a little bit and talking about their replacements.
Tyler Downauer, linebacker number 12, is out tonight with a hip injury. He is being replaced by Wilson Lee, the sophomore. And at the guard, Joe Howard is getting the start, number 59, the senior, for the offensive side.
Okay. Rochester has won the toss. They have elected to defer to the second half, which means the explosive offense of the Eastbrook Panthers. And Jacob Singer will get the football first here at Rochester High School. Brad, another beautiful night here to start the regular season. Not a cloud in the sky and a light wind out of the north. It's perfect.
Yeah, about 75 degrees.
Yep.
Blue skies, like you said, yeah, can't get any better for high school football.
You know, talking about Wilson Lee, Travis just mentioned him. He is going to be the field goal kicker this year for the Rochester Zebras. And, of course, when John Odell left because of graduation, that's a huge void there.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, this kid was hitting 30, 35 yarders in the pregame. It's kind of like it's kind of a straight-on motion by Wilson Lee, but he was fairly accurate.
Well, that's good. I mean, you get down inside that 20 and you need to get a field goal. That's what you need, 35 yards.
The Rochester Zebras will kick to our right. They are wearing black pants, black jerseys, gold numbers, and black helmets. The Eastbrook Panthers, gray pants, white jerseys, black numbers and letters, and black helmets. Brad Thomas, Travis Watchering, I'm David Musselman. First game of the regular season is moments away here at Rochester High School. We'll be following other games around the area, the Winnemac Knox game, Tippecanoe New Valley Academy game, Caston in action tonight with,
I didn't see who.
Triton.
That's right.
And North Miami and McConaughey playing. In fact, North Miami strikes first early. McConaughey scores?
14-0.
14-0. McConaughey's up in North Miami.
3 minutes ago in the first quarter.
Yowza. So Patrick Hayes, the All-State defensive end for the Rochester Zebras, will kick to the Panthers. Again, going to our right.
Not sending Singer deep.
That surprised me a little bit. In fact, too. I don't even see Singer on the return team.
No.
Burton is back deep. I believe also back deep for Eastbrook is Wright. And Garrett Winget is back as well.
A little different for them. Singer's been the return man the last few years.
Yeah. Doesn't hurt my feelings.
No,
sure.
Probably won't hurt him any either.
Alex Campbell to receive it. The kick is off the side of the foot of Kays, and one of the front guys for Eastbrook slides on it and picks it up at about the 31-yard line. So Eastbrook will start at their own 31, going to our left, going right into the sun, Brad, which is fairly significant at this time of year.
Yeah, and I think very few teams will come out the first game of the season and throw it on the first few series, but you never know. But, tonight you got the sun staring Eastbrook right in the face. They may opt to not do that.
So first and 10 for the Panthers at their own 31-yard line, going to our left. Ball in the far hash.
So far, so good.
Singer is your senior quarterback under center. Moore goes in motion to the right side. He gives to Burton, the first man through. Burton dodges one tackler and maybe gets a yard after first contact of the line of scrimmage. He falls forward to maybe the 32. It'll be second down and 8 for the Eastbrook Panthers. Second down and 8 for the Panthers. Singer gives to the motion man Martin, coming around the near side, and he is driven out of bounds at around the 40-yard line. We'll wait to see exactly where they spot that. Actually, he's going to stop out well short of the 40, give him the 37. Pickup of near 5 yards, which will bring up third down and a long 3 for Eastbrook, and they are quickly to the line of scrimmage. And under center in the no-huddle offense, Singer sets the line. In motion comes Moore to the near side. Back to pass to Singer. Rolls to the right side. Here comes Kays on his heels. He tucks it. He runs. He's looking for the first down marker. Has first down. Down the far sideline. Out of bounds. Right in close to midfield. And a first down for the Eastbrook Panthers.
I thought Kays almost had a sack right there. He missed him just by a foot.
And you saw right there the experience of Singer. He almost looked like he had another gear or two. And he tucked it about 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage and 15 yards up the field. He has a first down. And it's first and 10 at their own 48-yard line. Ball in the far hash. Again, Eastbrook going to our left. The no huddle offense for Singer and company. Under center now is Jacob Singer. Moore comes in motion to the near side. On the option, Singer keeps it around the near side. Nobody home. He's across 50. He's across 45 and brought down near the 41-yard line.
That's that's what we talked about earlier about staying home with the linemen. They all went right and Singer went left. They just got to follow him as well.
That ball, that's going to be enough for a Eastbrook first down.
Matt Basham on the tackle for the Zebras.
First and 10 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 41-yard line. Again, early in this contest, just under a minute, 11 minutes to play here in the first quarter. Singer with more in motion to the near side. Gives to Martin, sidesteps one tackler, lowers his head. Crawl falls across the 40 down to around the 38. Pickup of near 3 yards. It'll be second down and 7 for the Panthers. Eastbrook putting together a nice drive here. Eastbrook back to the line of scrimmage. No huddle for them. Singer looks to his sideline for the play. Now relays that play to the line of scrimmage and his backs. Now up under center from his own. I make that from Rochester's 38-yard line. Motion man. Burton gets the ball. First man through, and he is stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Very little there, if anything. It'll be third down and long for Eastbrook as he lost a foot or two.
Linebacker Street, he got in there right away. He saw there was no fake. Took down the back real quick.
Third down and 7 for the Eastbrook Panthers. Bringing a play in from the sideline is Tanner Wright, a 6-foot, 170-pound back. And he's going to be the quarterback now under center as Singer comes wide to the near side. So the backup quarterback Wright is now under center. And I'm not sure where Singer is, actually. And Martin gets the carry, and he is stacked up right at the line of scrimmage by Jay Heckathorn. And I'm not sure if Singer came out of the game or he stayed in. I don't see 10 anywhere on the field. It's going to be fourth down and about 6 after a yard gain. And a wholesale of changes for the Eastbrook Panthers on fourth down. And it looks like they will punt the ball away and back deep to kick. Garrett Winget. Rochester sending nobody back to receive the punt. So it'll be fourth and 6 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 37-yard line. Rochester expecting a punt. Eastbrook. And there's a flag on the play as everybody in the press box screaming delay of game. So it's going to back him up 5.
I'm not so sure they weren't trying to do that on purpose, just to give him a little more room to land the ball.
I'm still, folks, I apologize. I'm still kind of confused about that third down play when the backup quarterback Wright came in.
I don't know whether Singer, you know, blew a shoe or something. He had to go off for a play or...
Well, I thought Singer was punting, and now they have that Winget in, so he might have got hurt.
Winget just gets it away before the block of Basham comes, and it takes a Rochester bounce and comes to rest at about the 21-22-yard line. So Rochester does a great job there holding Eastbrook down with a no-huddle offense, and now they will go to work at their own 21- or 22-yard line. No score with 8:46 to play in the first quarter. First and 10 for Rochester, their own 21-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Now the Zebras going to our right. The Sun is to their back. Jay Heckathorn brings the play in from the sideline. Cy Holland relays it. We'll send Bennett wide to the near side. And the lone back is Streeton. Flanker to the right side is Houdeshell. Flanker to the left is Heckathorn. Cy Holland gives to Heckathorn, coming around the near side. He's got a lead blocker, slips down, and cannot regain his footing. And he slides down near the 20-yard line, so it looks like he might lose a yard on the play. It'll be second down and long for Rochester.
The guard on that, Austin Calvert, was his main blocker, and I think he slipped down, and Heckathorn might have went down with him.
Well, actually, he's going to say give him nothing. It'll be second down and 10 as he did get back to the line of scrimmage. In the game for the first time is Alec Garrick. He goes split to the left side, the wide side of the field. I-back formation for Cy Holland and company. Cy quickly gets the snap, gives to Houdeshell. And we're going to have a...
blown dead.
Yep, play is stopped before it even gets going. But yet I don't see any. Yep, there's a flag on the play. We're going to have a false start on the Rochester Zebras. So that'll back them up 10. It'll bring up second down and 15 with 8:05 to play in the first quarter. Penalty. Brad Thomas, Travis Watchering, I'm David Musselman. First game of the regular season here at Rochester High School. Next week we are at Plymouth.
Always fun to play on Labor Day weekend. At Plymouth.
At Plymouth,
it's
yes.
It's a mess.
I suggest you leave early.
Yeah, like Thursday. Holland gives to Houdeshell, and he's dropped down for very little gain. In fact, he might have been dropped back at about the 15. So Eastbrook running the war up front right now. They're going to give him the line of scrimmage. It'll be third down and 15 for the Rochester Zebras deep in their own territory. Alec Garrick brings in the play from the sideline. Ball in the near hash for Rochester. Again, going to our right. Wide side of the field is the Eastbrook side. Garrick goes wide to the left side. Bennett wide to the near side. Kennedy split left. Here's a shotgun formation with Carter screened to the left of Cy Holland. Holland back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Throws down the near sideline. It is too high and over the head of Bennett. And will bring up fourth down and 15 for the Rochester Zebras and a punting situation.
Holland's pass just over the head of the receiver and out of bounds. So I don't think even if it had been low enough to catch it, he'd have been any good.
Fourth down and 15 for the Rochester Zebras, and Patrick Hayes will punt from basically his goal line. Back deep is Winget, and also right for Eastbrook. The snap goes to Hayes, end over end kick, taken by the up man and right. And he feels it on his knees at about the 45-yard line for the Rochester Zebras. So, as you heard Coach Adams saying in the pregame, field position will be key in this football game. And already, Eastbrook backs up the offense, and Rochester kicks from the goal line. And Eastbrook here on their second tour takes over in pretty good field position.
That senior dominant line scrimmage for Eastbrook.
And the quarterback is going to be Tanner Wright again. The singer on the sideline, right under center. Martin comes to the near side on the option. Wright keeps it. It's spun down behind the line of scrimmage.
Jordan Schaefer for the Zebras.
Starter screen is there as well. And the quarterback, Wright, loses about three. It'll bring up second down and 13. No huddle offense for the Eastbrook Panthers. Wright looks to the sideline. Again, the fullback is Burton. Wing back to the left side is Moore. Wing back to the right side, or slot back, I should say, is Martin. He gets the handoff coming on the end around. And he is stacked up back at the original line of scrimmage. Maybe three on the play. It'll bring up third down and near 10. 10 and a half to 11 for the Eastbrook Panthers. Not a lot there. It's almost like Rochester not giving the quarterback position any respect now that 10's on the sideline. Right quickly under center. Drops the snap. Picks it up. Rolls right. And they're going to blow the play dead. Coach Jim Swangston on the sideline with his palms in the sky thinking and saying, what are we doing? So the official will come to the near side. I don't have any idea what that means. It looks like they're going to replay it.
Huh. Yep, that's exactly what they're going to do.
Third down and 11 for Eastbrook. As Zoda and Morio split to the right side. Right under center, Wilson wide to the near side. Lone back in the backfield is Burton. Slot to the right side is Martin. Right under center on 3rd and 11. Back to pass, three-step job. Jump throw to Moore is incomplete, and that's going to bring up a punting situation for Eastbrook on 4th down and 11.
Nice job by the Zebra defense. They had about four of them in the backfield right in Wright's face.
They were trying to run that screen pass, and I think all the linemen...
They were taller than he thought they were.
He jumped up in the air, kind of like that Tebow throw.
Well, that's exactly what I was going to say. Last person I saw that make that work was Tim Tebow. He'll be cut this week, I'm sure. The kick by Winget off the side of his foot. Bounces inside the 20-yard line, near the 15, maybe rolls inside the 15, around the 12 or 13-yard line.
We're going to have a penalty coming against the Zebras.
So Rochester with a football before the penalty, inside the 15-yard line. And it looks like they're going to be whistled for the penalty. Unsportsmanlike.
Yep.
And that'll back them up half the distance. So 5:43 to play in the first quarter. No score here at Rochester. And Rochester last possession ended by punting from their goal line. This possession will begin inside the 10.
They got it marked at about the 13, it looks like.
I don't know, Brad. I think they're going to mark that thing inside the five. It looks like at about
the
four.
Yeah, you're right. They did. They had the, on the ball on the sideline, though. They had set it at about the 13, but then they moved it back another 5 yards. So,
first down and a 10 for the Rochester Zebras at around the 5 yard line with 5:43 to play in the first quarter. Cy Holland under center, I-backs behind him. He gets the green light from the official, now under center. Schaefer gives the snap to Cy Holland. Now we're going to have a loose ball, and I believe Rochester falls on the loose ball. No harm, no foul there, except for it's going to bring up second down and long deep in their own territory. Second down and 10. Looks like the ball spotted about the 7 yard line. Jay Heckathorn brings in the play from the line, from the sideline. Holland brings the troops to the line of scrimmage. Bennett comes wide to the near side. Heckathorn split left. I backs for Cy Holland. Kennedy tight left. Second down and 10. Holland in the center with six. Gets the handoff to Heckathorn. They bang shoulders in the backfield. Heckathorn drags a couple of tacklers with him across the line of scrimmage and picks up about three. It'll bring up second to third down and seven with 4:40 to play in the first quarter. No score here at Rochester.
At CMA with 9:30 left in the first quarter, Valley's up 7-0.
Quantico is up on North Miami 21-0 after the first quarter.
Okay. No kidding. Welcome back to North Miami, Coach LeFevre. 4.5 minutes to play. First quarter, no score. Rochester breaks the huddle with seven on the play clock. They'll send two receivers on the near side, Bennett and Garrick. We're down to 4-3. Back to pass to Cy Holland. Here comes the back pressure from the backside. Throws it over the middle. Complete to Kennedy. Kennedy then is collared down after about a first down carry. Giving him about the 23-yard line.
Heck of a job for the offensive line. Kaysley, Schaefer, Calvert. Cy Holland had all the time he needed back there.
13-yard pitch and catch from Cy Holland to Luke Kennedy. And it was the first down for Rochester this season. Bennett, split left. I believe Heckerslern out there with him. Cy Holland into center. I-backs behind him. Kennedy tight right. Streeton gets the carry up the middle. Carter Streeton falls across the 30 to around the 31. Nice hard run for Streeton of about 7 or 8 yards. It'll bring up second and short for Rochester at about their own 31-yard line with 3:40 to play in the first quarter. Again, no score here at Rochester. Schaefer comes to the line of scrimmage, the center for Rochester. Garrett goes split left. Bennett split to the near side. Near side is short side of the field. How to make that, how to shell offset to the left. Here's a snap to Holland. Is that Streeton again getting to the 35? It is. Carter Streeton gets out to the 35-yard line to pick up a four and another Rochester first down. Great job by the guys up front for the Rochester offensive line.
That's two plays they ran to the left. That's credit to Braxton Lee and Pat Kays, the guard and tackle, pushing down on the line and giving Streeton and Holland enough time to run a play and get some yards.
3 minutes to play, first quarter. Rochester first and 10 at their own 35-yard line. Bennett wide to the near side. A slot to the right side is Hattishell. Slot to the left side is Heckathorn. The carry goes to Streeton. Streeton dodges one tackler. Stone is looking at the 40, the 45, the 50, and gets to midfield. Another big Rochester first down of 15 yards.
Nice run by Streeton. He was able to cut back after he got past the initial line of scrimmage and pick up another 8 or 9 yards.
Tripped up at the line of scrimmage and kept his footing and, like I said, picked up 15 yards. First down and 10 for Rochester at midfield. Bennett comes wide to the near side, ball in the middle of the field. The flanker to the left side is Heckathorn. Flanker to the near side is Hattishell. Streeton, lone man behind Holland. Cy under center. Gives to Heckathorn, coming to the near side, has a blocker in front of him, kicks it out to the near sideline, and is flips up at the 41. A gain of about 9 yards, so nice job for Jay Heckathorn and the blocking out
Jacob
front.
Jacob Hattishell.
Number 20, Jacob Hattishell. That was Hattishell. Big block for him.
Hattishell, yep. Was able to get the corner sealed so he can get up the field.
Austin Calvert was a lead blocker out there as well for the Rochester Zebras. Second and one for the Z's. Now at Eastbrook's 41-yard line with 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Garrett goes split left. Kennedy tight left. Holland under center. Gives to Hadashell up the middle. Jacob Hadashell, the 30, the 25, the 20, and dragged down at about the 19-yard line. A huge run for Jacob Hadashell, and a Zebra first down.
Kaysen Lee again. They keep attacking that left side. Kaysen Lee are having their day down there with those linemen.
Good 25-yard pickup for Jacob Hadashell. Credit the referee for sealing off the linebackers.
First and 10 for the Rochester Zebras inside the 20-yard line of the Eastbrook Panthers with 1:45 to play in the first quarter. Ball in the middle of the field. Holland breaks the huddle. We'll send the Zebras to the line of scrimmage. Heckathorn wide to the near side. Bennett split left, split backs for Holland with Kennedy tied to the right side. The second man through his street and bounced up, or actually bottled up at the line of scrimmage and pushed backwards. He'll lose about two. It'll bring up second down and 11 with 1:25 to play in the first quarter. No score here at Rochester High School. Brad Thomas, Travis Watring, I'm David Musselman. Rochester putting together a nice drive here. Their second possession of the game.
10th play of the drive already. They've had the ball for 6 minutes.
Outstanding. Ball on the near side of the field. Garrick split left, split backs for Holland. Sy under center. Schaefer the center with a snap. Holland gives it to Hadashell right in the middle. Jacob Hadashell lowers his head. He gets inside the 15. Near the 13-yard line. And third down and manageable now for the Rochester Zebras with 40 seconds to play in the first quarter.
I think he stuck his head down, followed the center, Jordan Schaefer, and got exactly what he needed.
Third down and about two for the Rochester Zebras with 30 seconds to play in the first quarter. In the second quarter, West Central and Culver tied at six. Holland under center with 22. Split backs behind him. Hadashell again. Right side. Backs his way to the 10. We got a flag on the play. He's got enough for a first down, but what's the flag?
Thrown in the Rochester backfield. That could be anything from holding to a face mask. We'll see what they...
Braxton Lee got up holding his head, and I think he was hurt. We got him a personal foul. A fist to the head on Eastbrook.
Yep.
So that's
going
to move him half a distance to the goal line and a first down for the Rochester Zebras.
Rochester line, front lineman doing a great job of neutralizing that push from the Eastbrook defensive lineman. Running backs are able to get into that.
So the ball, I'm sorry.
No, go right ahead.
The ball just inside the 5-yard line for Rochester. First and goal for the Zebras inside Eastbrook's 5. And that's going to do it for the first quarter. After one here at Rochester, we are scoreless. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WR.
Street and Hadashell, whoever it is, can get the yards they need.
I don't think that surprises too many people. Pat Kay's at 6'4", 203 pounds.
Absolutely.
Senior.
You know, this is what I like. I don't know how many plays Rochester's run on this series, but they've had the ball for about 8.5 minutes.
8.5 minutes, and they're running their 13th play right now.
Zebras coming to the line of scrimmage. Ball just inside the 5. Everybody in tight. Bennett tight left. Kennedy tight right. Straight T backfield for Cy Holland. First and goal for Rochester at Eastbrook's 5. And then Zebras jump. Back him up 5. It'll be first and goal from the 10.
Well, that's your first game mental mistake right there.
So Rochester will have it first and goal from the 10 after the 5-yard mark off.
That's their third penalty now for a loss of 20 yards.
And the Zebras already being attended to for maybe some cramping on the sideline. Straighten, Hadashell, Heckathorn in a straight T formation. Holland gives to Hadashell, left side. Jacob Hadashell picking his way through traffic, falling towards the goal line.
Where's the signal?
The Zebras calling for a touchdown, nothing doing. Give him 9, it'll be second and goal from the 1.
Good run by Jacob Hadashell, just tripped up short.
Second and goal from the 1 for the Rochester Zebras. Garrick brings the play in from the sideline. Jay Heckathorn comes out. 11:30 to play in the first half. Rochester, second and goal from the 1. Hadashell, Screeton, Garrick, left to right. Two tight ends for Rochester from the 1-yard line. Hadashell, right side, lowers his head, pushes his way towards the goal line, looking for the call. It is going to be short. Again, and it's going to be third and goal from about the one-inch line.
All the Zebras with their hands up, but the officials aren't giving it to them.
Third and goal. What do you do here, Travis?
I think you got to run again, and why not go to the left side?
Or does number five keep it?
That could happen, too.
I don't think Sy will keep it.
I don't like that idea. No, I think give it to your running back.
Streeten back in the game.
Job.
Follow the left side. Give the Zebras six points.
Leave without a shell. Give Streeten the ball.
Third and goal from the 1 foot line. Holland under center takes the snap. Gives to Hadashell. Left side tripped up. Falls in. Touchdown Zebras. Jacob Hadashell runs it in from a yard out, and the Zebras strike first. They're up 6-0. Jacob Hadashell, 1 yard touchdown run that puts the Zebras up 6-0 with 10.5 minutes to play in the second quarter. The kick coming for Rochester. Wilson Lee will do the kicking for the Zebras. A straight-on approach. Snap is back. Hold is down. Kick is away. It's going to make it, is it? Nope. I think it's just short, or maybe it's even wide to the right. So Rochester on the board, 6-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Don't miss the huge summer clearance event right now at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram in Winnemac. Have you seen the new 2014 Jeeps? Braun has them sitting on the lot, including Grand Cherokees and Patriots. Don't forget about the popular new Chrysler 200s and 300s, the good-looking new Dodge Journeys, the powerful new Ram trucks, and of course, the practical new Chrysler and Dodge minivans. Great prices on our great selection of new vehicles, and well worth your drive to check out the summer clearance event going on now at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram, US 35 South in Winnemac.
This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, the Zebras strike first on a 1 yard touchdown run by Jacob Hadashell. The kick failed. Right now, Zebras lead 6-0 with 10:35 to play in the first half. Travis, a scoring drive.
They had the ball for 10 minutes with 15 plays. Incredible how they traveled 93 yards.
That's right. That's exactly right. And it'll be interesting to see if Singer comes off the sideline to quarterback the team. They are a totally different team when Wright is their quarterback.
You're right. And you said it earlier, they don't have to spy on him like they do Singer. When Singer's in the game, you've got to have somebody paying attention to him.
So Patrick Hayes, the kick. Hayes, end over end, low line drive kick. Comes to the short man, the up man, and Campbell. And Campbell tries the left sideline, and is finally tackled near the 30-yard line. So Eastbrook will start there. Again, Rochester up 6-0 with 10:28 to play in the first half.
With 6:11 left in the first quarter, CMA kicks a field goal. Valley leads 7-3.
Also in McQuonicall, North Miami, McQuonicall is up 34-0 in the second quarter.
First and 10 for Eastbrook. At their own 29-yard line, going to our right, ball in the far hash.
Warsaw, Columbia City, time 7-7.
It looks like Wright is the quarterback again, indeed.
Yes, he is.
Wright is under center. Wright gives to Burton right up the middle. Burton dodges one tackler, lowers his head, and falls across his 45-yard line near the 46. A huge gain for the senior. Zach Burton, the 5'9", 155-pound fullback, and he gets it out to the 45, a first down for Eastbrook.
It was a great round for Burton. He broke about two tackles. He got enough for the first.
Winget is the slot back to the right side now. Moore on the left side. Burton is your fullback. Again, Wright. Tanner Wright under center, the quarterback for Eastbrook. Moore comes in motion to the near side. On the option, Burton right up middle again on second and third effort. Gets close to the 48-yard line as he dives forward for about 3 yards.
He was stacked up at the line of scrimmage and managed to break free.
Giving four, it'll be second down and six. What has happened to Jacob Singer? Right under center, Widget in motion. Burton again, left side. Burton lowers his head. second ever. Gets him close to the sticks. He'll be short of a yard. It'll be a pickup of five. It'll be third down and one, just shy of Rochester's 45-yard line.
Well, I'll tell you what,
Eastbrook.
If Singer can't go tonight, that's going to level the playing field tremendously.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
I don't even see Singer on the sidelines.
I
wonder if he went in the locker room, get taped, something happened.
Something, yeah.
Third and inches for Eastbrook at Rochester's 46. Burton again right side, and second effort gets him the first down as Basham had him behind the line of scrimmage. He spun away just briefly from Basham and picked up enough for another Eastbrook first down. Give him two.
Nice job by Basham.
Yeah, Matt had him wrapped up, and Burton tried to spin out of it. He took him down hard.
Alex Campbell, now your fullback for Eastbrook. Quickly, right under center. And ball's loose. And Campbell, who just came into the game, falls on the loose ball back at Rochester's 49-yard line. So he's going to lose about six. It'll bring up second down and 16.
It was like Wright walked away from the center, and the ball just rolled out from underneath.
Campbell is lucky he got to that. There's a herd of zebras going after that football on the ground.
Yeah, you're right. So quickly on the ball are the Eastbrook Panthers, right under center. Campbell, your fullback. Moore, slot back to the near side. Winges, slot back to the left side. In motion is Moore. Back to passes right. Looks left. Throws left. Has a wide open receiver. Winges complete. Winges at the 15. And now at the 10. Now dodges another tackle with a 5. Winges to the end zone. Touchdown, Eastbrook. A 49-yard pitch and catch from right to Winges. And Eastbrook has just tied the score at 6. Tanner Wright throws a strike to a wide open Garrett Winget, and Garrett Winget did a nice dance move or two down the field and got it in after 49 yards and ties this game. And now the kicker is going to be Luke Elliott, a 5'9 sophomore. As you know, yeah, Singer Singer is on the bench.
Yep.
There's the kick. It's a high, short kick. Is it going to make it? It is. Ugh. It went about 20 feet in the air, and I don't know, about 20 feet, and just fell over the crossbar.
Just missed the crossbar, yeah.
Eastbrook leads 7-6. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Football, WROI, Rochester, Indiana. And we're all
If you've never visited All About Pets downtown Rochester, why not give them a try? Because they really are all about pets. They're dedicated to bringing the area the finest in pet foods and treats, pet toys, pet health care supplies, an entire room of fish and aquarium supplies, small animal food, pet accessories, just about anything and everything you need for your pet right here locally. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street, Rochester. Locally owned and operated to enhance the happy of your pet. If your pet is looking a little shaggy, call 223-8444 473 and inquire about their grooming service for pets. And we're all
about pets. This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
8:37 to play in the second quarter, and after a 49-yard touchdown pass, the Eastbrook Panthers on the board, and now they lead the Rochester Zebras 7-0. The kickoff is low, end over end, picked up by Rochester. Basham gets crushed by his own man. I believe that was Basham. And Rochester starts just shy of the 35-yard line. Yeah, Basham, and he comes up limping a little bit. I believe he and Travis McClain just blew it up, each other up. Travis, the scoring drive.
The Panthers scored quick there. They had the ball for 2.5 minutes on 6 plays to a wide-open wing it for a 49-yard touchdown.
Wide open. There wasn't anybody within 15 yards of him on that pass.
Only the second pass of the game for Eastbrook.
First and 10 for Rochester at their own 37-yard line. Going into the sun now with 8.5 minutes to play in the first half. Again, Eastbrook up 7-6. Hadashell offset to the left side. He gets a carry off the left side. Hattischel just about loses the football, spins around, regains the pigskin, and then carries the ball out to the 45-yard line where he picks up near 8. It'll be second down and 2 for Rochester, and the ball in the middle of the field.
A great block by the senior, Pat Kays, the 6'4". He had that kid down as soon as Cy said hike, I think.
You know, he's a sophomore. As Hattischel probably not that strong as a sophomore, probably loses that football.
Yeah, you're right. He did a good job of hanging on to it. Spun him completely around, but he was able to keep hold of the ball.
Second down and 2 for Rochester. Bennett goes wide to the near side, wide to the far side. Kennedy tight left. Slot backs for Rochester. Heckathorn comes in motion to the near side. Holland gives to Streeton. Streeton left side, ducks his head, and gets enough for a Rochester first down as they're getting very close to the Eastbrook 48-yard line. Give him 3. It'll be first and 10 for the Zebras as the clock rolls with 7:45 to play in the first half. Again, Eastbrook up 7-6.
Streeton didn't quite look like he wanted to run headlong into that Eastbrook defense. He just wanted to get enough for the first down.
Yeah. First and 10 for Rochester, their own 48. Bennett split to the right side, wide side of the field. Slot to the left side, or flanker to the left side, is Garrick. Cy Holland under center. Gives to Streeton, and he tiptoes again to the line, Brad, and
yeah,
gets nothing.
He's mad a yard deep in the backfield, too. He managed to... No, he didn't manage. He did lose a yard.
So Carter Streeton loses a yard. It'll be second down and 11 back at the 47-yard line. Clock is running with 7:15 to play in the first half.
I'm not sure which Panther came up with that tackle, but I think he was unblocked. And
yeah, there was about 3 of them in the backfield waiting there for Streeton.
We did see Jacob Singer, the starting quarterback for Eastbrook. He is on the sideline. He is on the bench. He's got his shoulder pads off. It looks like he's icing his left shoulder is what it looked like.
Yeah.
Second and 11 for Rochester. Down to 5 on the play clock. I formation for Holland. Back to pass. Cy with a lot of time to throw. Rolls right side. Throws it up for grabs. It is complete to Kennedy. And then Kennedy is brought down to the Eastbrook 46-yard line. It'll be third down and about 4 or 5 for the Zebras.
Cy just threw that ball up there. And
please, somebody come down with that in black uniform.
6'4", Kennedy got the ball before the 5'9 defensive backs the Panthers have.
I don't think Cy was quite ready to throw it, but he didn't have any choice. He was going down.
Either that or going out of bounds.
Yeah.
That's what's nice, though, about having Luke Kennedy starting out there. He is 6'4", 6'3", and the tallest defensive back Panthers have is 5'9".
Yeah.
Even with Bennett out there.
Bet.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We have a nice little height advantage.
Third down and 4 for Rochester at Eastbrook's 46-yard line. Ball on the far hash. And Rochester's having all sorts of trouble.
Yep. Zahner calls timeout.
Formation-wise, so we're going to take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Is your water softener on the job protecting you from higher energy bills, dingy laundry, and spotted dishes? A water softener can save you as much as 20% of your energy bill, but only if your water softener has been set properly for hardness and your water use. Water stores and home improvement stores don't size properly because they don't have enough choices. For more choices, HomeSol delivery to any brand softener and a 30-day satisfaction guarantee, call Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2420. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
This is Zebra Football. 2.1 WROI.
Minute, 26 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester uses a timeout and looking at third down and 4 from Eastbrook's 46-yard line. Holland under center. Ball on the far hash going to our left for the Zebras. We're going to have 2 minutes
in motion.
Nice use of time. And then Rochester loses the football. So the play does not stop because of 2 minute motion.
Eastbrook says they've got it.
And Eastbrook falls on the football. And now we're waiting for the official word. Is that a dead ball with 2 minute motion?
It should be because they would throw the flag and blow the play dead. So
Eastbrook fans and the coaching staff pointing their end. The officials have converged. And it doesn't look like they're going to give the ball to Eastbrook. Rochester is going to keep possession the way it looks.
Typically, when you have an offensive motion penalty like that, they stop the play.
And yet, no signal from the official. Even obviously, it was.
They haven't changed it on the
chain gang yet.
So that means they blew the play dead.
Yeah.
They should, yeah. They would have had to.
So we are. We're still on offense.
So Rochester loses about 2 yards.
But they're not going to mark off the penalty. So what are they going to? They got to mark off the 5-yard penalty here. You would, but they're not. They're putting it right back to where it was at. Wow. So Rochester keeps the ball. They don't lose any yardage on the penalty.
And it's going to be 3rd and 4 so again.
And they don't lose a down. It's just basically a replay.
What is going on? And then, yeah, now the sideline judge on the Eastbrook side of the field is coming in and said, look,
we didn't mark.
It's either going to be Eastbrook's football or we're going to mark off 5 yards.
Yeah, exactly. Now they're sending Kennedy off the field, but they haven't changed the ball any. So well, now they're saying that Kennedy substituted in, but he can't substitute on a dead play. So that's the only thing I can think of. They've had to have called the play dead and doing a replay.
So it'll be 3rd down and 4 from the 46. I don't know how. Twins on the near side for Rochester. Holland under center. Holland fakes the handoff. Back to pass play action. Throws down the near sideline looking for Bennett. It's going to be incomplete, but I believe we're going to have pass interference on Moore
pushing
for Eastbrook and a 1st down for the Zebras.
Oh, pushing the back.
Good heavens.
Now we'll see if they mark this one off.
No. Well, they might take this one to the 10.
Okay. Well, I can't believe Eastbrook's coach wasn't out on the field protesting that one.
Whoa, that was on Rochester.
I think Bennett got caught on pushing the back on him. Trying to get three in.
Offensive pass interference.
So it's going to be offensive pass interference on him.
Mark that 20 yards.
Bennett. And it's going to back him up inside their own 40-yard line back to the 39.
Holy cow.
Holy moly. Maybe they since they forgot to add 5 yards for the...
I'm thinking we're going to have to take an algebra class to figure this one out. X equals...
3rd and 20 for Rutt. Oh, now we're going to
move it. Now we're going to
go forward. We're going to back to the original line of scrimmage.
Up. I told you.
Those refs are just excuses we are.
Oh, okay. Eastbrook refused the penalty. Okay.
4th down. Holy smokes.
Lord almighty. 4th and 4 for Rochester. They will go for it. Now Coach Zander will use a timeout. In the 60, you're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
You can actually trade in your current car for a new Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram and get the same or even lower payments.
You heard right. Mike Anderson Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram is hosting a trade-up sales event where
you can trade in your current car for a new Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram and get the same or lower payments.
Unbelievable, but it's true. Stop by Mike Anderson until Labor Day and we'll show you how we've helped hundreds of satisfied customers trade in their current vehicles for a brand new vehicle
with the same payment or less.
Plus, with end of summer back to school specials, we have even more ways to lower your payment. With so much to offer and so much to save, you can't afford to miss this event. Instead of just trading in, trade up at the summer clearance event at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, 1702 Main Street in Rochester. Visit MikeAndersonCDJ.com for more details.
This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, well, it's 4th down and 4 for Rochester. They will go for it at the Eastbrook 46-yard line. Holland under center, split back behind him, 2 wideouts, 1 to each side. Holland looking to draw Eastbrook offsides. Takes the snap, gives to Hadashell, left side. He is going to be close to the chain. He's going to be close to the 1st down marker. The far side says he's got it. We'll wait and see. He is really close to the 40. Give him the 41. He eyes it, and the official gives him the 1st down. That's a big play for Rochester and Jacob Hadashell as he picks up 4 and another Zebra 1st down.
He ran right behind that left side again, Pat Kays and Braxton Lee. So much faith Coach Zander has in those two right now.
6:10 to play in the first half. Eastbrook leading 7-6. Rochester 1st and 10 at the Panther 41-yard line. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Ball in the near hash for the Zebras. Hecathorn, flanker to the near side. Hadashell, flanker to the right side. Lone back is Screeton. Hadashell gives to Hecathorn. Now to Hadashell. Hadashell spins and brought down at about the 32. Actually, Holland gives to Hecathorn, then to Hadashell. And Hadashell takes it to the 32-yard line to pick up a near 9. It'll be 2nd down and 1 for the Z's.
Some local scores. We have Warsaw and Columbia City tied 7-7. Triton over Caston 18-0. Mississinawa and Manchester are tied. Wallasee is over Whitco 14-0. Culver is beating West Central. Culver and West Central are tied at the half.
Okay, thank you. Second and one. Holland to Hattishell. Hattishell backs his way inside the 30, down to around the 28, 27-yard line, and another Zebra first down.
Both hands wrapped around that football was Hattishell.
Give him the 27. It'll be first and 10 for the Z's.
At the end of the first quarter at CMA, Culver come back to take the lead 9-7 over Tippecanoe Valley.
Okay.
We also have Lewis Cass over Pioneer 14-0.
That's usually a good game to start.
A lot of goose eggs out on the scoreboard tonight.
5 minutes to play, first half. Eastbrook leading 7-6. The Zebras have the football on the near sideline on Eastbrook's 27-yard line.
Another long drive for the Zebras.
Tenth play, has had the ball for 5 minutes.
Screen gets the carry. Screen lowers his head, gets to the 25, maybe inside the 25.
A lot better look from Screeton that time. Like you said, put his head down, went hard.
They're going to spot the ball just inside the 25-yard line. Give him 2 yards. It'll be second down and 8. Clock rolls at 4.5 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester trails Eastbrook 7-6. And about the second or third play of the game is what I'm going to guess. Jacob Singer, the star quarterback for Eastbrook, was knocked out of the game. Second down and 8 for Rochester. Split backs for Cy Holland. Holland takes the snap from Schaefer, gives a screen again, right side. Screen calls the tackler to the 20, give him 4. And it'll be third down and manageable for the Z's at the Eastbrook 20.
And I still see Singer sitting on the sidelines to see his pads on the ground and ice around him. So
yeah, I'm guessing he won't be back tonight.
I can't imagine he'll be back in the second half.
Third and 3 for the Z's at the 20-yard line of Eastbrook. Bennett goes wide to the far side. Heckathorn split to the near side. Hattishell offset left for Rochester and Holland. Hattishell has it left side. Hattishell kicks it out to the outside. The 10, the 5, touchdown Zebras!
Outstanding again by that left side. Hattishell ran right behind Casey Schaefer and got 6 points on the board.
Jacob Hattishell, a 20-yard touchdown run to put the Z's up 12-7.
I know. Thank you.
With 3:39 to play in the first half, and Lee will try to put the extra point through. Rochester. And the PAT coming. Snap is back. Hold us down. Kick is away. It looks good. It is good. 13-7 Rochester. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI.
RTC, your locally owned telecommunications provider, is here to make your communications world easier so you have more time to do what you like enjoying sports. At RTC, they're proud to bring you RTC Telephone, Fiber Connect high-speed internet, and cable television in digital and high def. For information, call 574-223-2191. Be sure and watch Channel 4, your only local access channel for Zebra football action from Friday night's game. Broadcast time, 10 a.m. Saturday morning. RTC, local products, local support, local investment.
This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
3 minutes, 39 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester regains the lead at 13-7 after a 20-yard touchdown run by Jacob Hattishell, Travis.
They had 11 plays with 5 minutes to take off the clock, and like you said, a 20-yard touchdown finished off by Hattishell.
Brady, it was a great run because at about the 17-18-yard line, Hattishell made one quick sidestep left, and it went to the house.
Then outran the secondary to the end zone. Yeah, you're right. They had the ball right in the center of the field for the snap, and he had plenty of room to work that sideline.
Winget, Campbell.
Freeman, 7-0 in the end of the first quarter.
Back deep to receive the kick from Taze. Taze, nice end-over-end kick, high kick. Comes down to the 14-yard line. The reverse is faked by Eastbrook.
Good job by John Hunting. He wasn't fooled at all.
And Burton carries the ball out across the 30 to around the 32-yard line. So Eastbrook in pretty good field position here to start this series with 3:33 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester up 13-7.
Another local score, we have Plymouth over Bremen, 7-0 in the second quarter.
Okay. Of course, we'll see the Rockies next week. Right, quickly under center. Motion man coming to the near side. The counter play goes left, and I believe that was Martin. I'll have to wait and see as he gets up off the ground. I believe it was Martin gets a couple. Or did he get nothing? The flag hasn't moved yet. I don't think he got anything there, did he? Second and 10.
No, linebacker Braxton Lee got in there pretty quick, and I don't think they gained any yards.
Quickly, Eastbrook on the ball with 3 minutes to play in the first half. Right under center. Back to pass. Three-step drop, looking left. Here comes some pressure. Switches directions. Comes to the near side. Runs into his own man, and then runs into the Zebras. And he escapes. And it's picked up by Rochester. Ran about 30 yards in his backfield. He hit his own man. He hit three Zebras. He fumbled the football, and then Rochester fell on it.
I think Pat Case caused the fumble, but it's hard to tell.
And Heckathorn picked up the loose ball, so great job by the Zebras.
There's about five Zebras in the backfield. It's hard to tell who caused it, who picked it up.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Rochester Zebras at Eastbrook's 24-yard line.
That was Taylor Pugh on the recovery. My mistake.
I beg your pardon, at the 19-yard line. I'm sorry?
Taylor Pugh with the recovery.
Okay, Taylor Pugh.
3 minutes to go, plenty of time to score again.
Ball virtually in the middle of the field. Heckathorn goes split to the right side. Hattischel offset right. Kennedy tight right, Bennett tight left. Cy Holland under center from inside the 20 of Eastbrook. Holland takes the snap from Schaefer. Pitches to Streeton. Then hands off to Heckathorn. Jay Heckathorn gets a block in front of him. Dodges one tackler and is cut down at near the 10-yard line. Give him 9. It'll be first down. Makes that second and 1 for the Zebras.
He got a big block from Luke Kennedy, the senior. On that second reverse, Kennedy stayed back and hit someone coming to get him.
So Heckathorn comes out of the game. Derek will bring the play in from the sideline. It'll be second and 1 for Rochester with 2.5 minutes to play. In the first half, leading 13-7.
Good execution by the offense on that reverse.
Zebras come to the line. They'll have two tight ends, Kennedy right, Bennett left. Straight T backfield. Behind Holland. From the 10, Holland takes the snap. Hattischel hitting the backfield. Tries to spin away from the tackler. Nothing doing. He's going to lose a couple. That's going to bring up third down at about 4 or 5 for Rochester. .155 to play in the first half. Rochester up 13-7. And they have it now, third down and 4. Back at about the 13-14-yard line of the Eastbrook Panthers.
Defensive end for the Panthers stayed home right there. Again, he was unblocked, and he got in the backfield pretty quick.
Straight T look again. Two tight ends for Cy Holland. Quick snap. Almost loses the football. Back to pass. Throws right. Has Kennedy in the back of the end zone. Off his fingertips. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down and 4.
He threw that little high to Kennedy. I think that's what you got to do with him with the height advantage he has over the Panther back.
Holland sidestepping the rush from the defensive end. Did a good job just getting that ball to Kennedy.
I was going to say, that didn't turn out very well. He's bobbling the snap, and Wilson Lee will come on to attempt a field goal.
These are the ones Wilson Lee is hitting during warm-up. Let's see if he can do it again.
So Wilson Lee will look to attempt a 30-yard field goal. The ball will be kicked from the 20-yard line.
Left hash.
Yep, you're right.
The sun has set. That'll help.
1.5 minutes to play in the first half. It'll be fourth down and 4 for Rochester. The holder is Kennedy, it looks like. Snap is back. Hold is down. Wilson puts his right foot into it. It looks long enough. It looks good. It is good.
Great job.
A 30-yard field goal for Wilson Lee, and the Zebras are up 16-7. How about that?
Just like in practice.
Just like they drew it up. With 1:25 to play in the second quarter, Rochester's now up 16-7 here at Barnhart Field.
4.5 yards. That's outstanding for Wilson Lee just to come out there and be able to kick that field goal. I mean, with John Odell in the past, I mean, he's been kicking Zebras the last 3 or 4 years.
You're right.
New kicker, maybe a new dynasty for Wilson Lee.
He might have had another 5 yards on that one yet.
You're right.
So.
I agree.
Yeah.
So it's 16-7 for the Rochester Zebras with 1:25 to play in the first half.
They had the ball for only a minute and got 4 plays out of it, but they got the 3 points they needed.
That's right. More importantly, now a two-possession game for Eastbrook. I know it's pretty early in the game to be talking about that, but you never can tell.
All right. Well, the scenario for the last 3 years have not seen the Zebras in the league.
Yeah,
so
you're
this
right.
This is a good position to be in.
Campbell, Winget, and Burton back deep receive the kick from Kays. Kays, low end-over end kick. Muffed by an up man for Eastbrook, picked up by Campbell, who goes left. and he is spun down near the 25-yard line. So Eastbrook, with all three of their timeouts, will have the football at about their 25 with a minute 21 to play in the first half. Rochester up 16-7.
Well, I'm guessing that Wright for Eastbrook probably didn't see a lot of snaps in practice in the last couple of weeks, and he's getting his fill of them tonight.
Yeah.
Maybe last couple of years.
Well, that may be true, too.
So it looks like Eastbrook will start about their own 22-23-yard line and quickly right to the line of scrimmage. Rochester scrambling to get in position. Wright fakes the pitch, gives to Burton near side. Burton gets it as a blocker in front of him and is hauled down from behind, but not until he gets out to about the 31-yard line. Give him nine. It'll be second down and one, but more importantly, clock rolls here. As don't forget, Rochester, they are up 16-7, but gets the football first to start the second half.
Senior Matt Basham came limping off. I think he's cramping again. And Connor McLaughlin, the freshman, is getting some minutes right
now. 58 seconds to play first half. Right at the line of scrimmage at second down and one. Takes a lot of time here. Sets his club on the option. He keeps it, flips it out to Martin, and Martin gets close to the first down marker, but the way it looks from here, he might have been stopped shy. It is. It's going to be third down and one, and he only got a yard.
Excellent job by Kyle Katschke. He only gives up about 100 pounds on Martin, and he still brought him down. Wrap the knees together. You can't run too easy.
25 seconds to play first half. Third down and one for Wright and Eastbrook. Down to 20. Martin goes in motion to the left side. Burton gets the carry right up the middle. Make that to Campbell, gets the carry, and he drags a tackler across the 40 down to the 41. And it's going to be enough for an Eastbrook first down.
Big tackle right there for Pat Kays. He about missed him, held onto his legs, and just took him down.
Ball at the 40-yard line of Eastbrook. No timeout used. They're down to 15 on the game clock. Wright relays the play from the wristband. Now under center with nine. Back to passes right, looking left. Here comes the pressure. Steps up at the pocket. He's going to keep it. He gets away from Kays. Comes to the near side. He's at the 50, the 45, and Heckethor runs him out of bounds as the clock strikes zero. At halftime, Zebras lead 16-7. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WR. We're at halftime. The Zebras leading 16-7. Both teams out of the locker room. Rochester will get to the ball to start the second half. Travis, you have some scores from around the area.
Possible for scores.
There you go. How about this?
Sectional opponent. Northwood is beating Jimtown 14-7, and Jimtown is a sectional opponent. Twin Lakes is over Logansport 10-0, and Twin Lakes is also a sectional opponent. Peru-Wabash, Peru is up 34-0. McQuonicall beats North Miami 48-0. Warsaw and Columbia City are tied 7-7. Triton's over Caston 18-0. Mississinawa still beating Manchester. Wallasee over Whitco 14-0. Culver is tied with West Central 6-6. Lewis Cass is up Pioneer 22-0.
West Central is leaving Culver 12-6.
12-6.
2 minutes left in the third.
Okay. And our opponent for next week, the Plymouth Rockies, are up on Bremen 14-0. And last, CMA is up 14-6 with three minutes left in the second half.
That's on Valley, and then Winnemac leading Knox at the break 35-0. So a lot of scores. We thank Val from the Sentinel for a lot of those.
And Jay Craig from Tippecanoe Valley.
Absolutely. Paul Hettinger with the Winnemac score, and also West Central score as well. So we thank a lot of people for giving us some scores tonight from around the area.
Scored again. So
really?
Yeah, 23-14. They still got 3 minutes to go before half, so that's they're falling behind on our game.
Well, when you score 100 points a half.
Yeah, you know, kid. Hey, you know what? Isn't technology great?
Absolutely.
We got what? The iPad, the computer, three cell phones up here. So, hey, if you want to listen to us, that you're going to be out of town, WROIFM.com.
That's right.
You hit the live stream, or I just mentioned three cell phones up here in the press box, and there's probably 15 of them up here if you look down the press row. But
people in the press box.
If you've got a smartphone and you want to take us with you, download the free app, TuneIn, TuneIn Radio. Click WROIFM, and you can listen to us anywhere you go.
I was in Schererville on Wednesday night, and obviously I can't get the radio up there, but I wanted to listen to the coach's preview show, and I used that.
Yeah, I was
used my Bluetooth.
I was at the State Fair week or so ago and listen to it down
good
there.
Stuff.
Yeah, it is.
So the Rochester Zebras will start the second half with the football. If you're just joining us, Rochester's up 16-7. Biggest news of the game, second play of the night. Jacob Singer, the All-State candidate, I'm guessing, for the Eastbrook Panthers, goes down with an injury. And not only is he not only is he on the sideline, he's got his pads off. And,
out of uniform.
Yep,
yeah.
And he's being iced. That's a big deal. Travis, take me through a mindset and maybe the locker room that when you look across the way and you know their very best player is not going to come back. In fact, this might be the best player that Rochester sees all year.
You know what? I mean, yeah, it has to be a confidence booster for the Zebras. Well, hopefully they keep the same mentality, the mindset that they had coming into the game thinking Singler was going to play. They have to keep the same mentality up, the same focus, the same pressure on whether it's Singler or a different quarterback in the game. The locker room had to be intense. They had to focus. I'm sure Coach Zahner was doing exactly what he was doing, talking to them about some plays or some blocks they might have missed, but for the most part, telling them, great job, keep doing it in the second half, and let's continue with the lead.
We touched on it just briefly late in that first quarter, early in the second quarter, how Rochester now kind of doesn't look at their offense as three-dimensional. It's almost like if you're not going to give it to Burton, then you're going to pitch it because we don't respect your quarterback.
I mean, Rochester's defense to Eastbrook.
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, that's worked. I mean, Rochester's defense is coming with the same intensity as they were for the first couple of plays with Singler in there, and Wright's just not the same kind of quarterback that Singler
right.
is.
Yep, you're right. So Eastbrook will start by kicking to the Rochester Zebras. Luke Elliott gets the green light, and here we go. Low, wobbly kick, picked up by Hadashell at the 25. Jacob Hadashell picks his way through traffic to 30, pushes his way ahead to close to the 35-yard line. So Rochester, in their first possession of the second half, will start in pretty good field position.
I'll tell you what, there was no shortage of confidence on that Rochester defense in the first half, and you could see the confidence growing in the offense as the game went on.
Singer is usually the kicker for the Panthers, and they had someone else out there, so it looks like second half without Singer again. Could be trouble for the Panthers.
Jacob Singer basically did everything for the Eastbrook Panthers.
since I gave you that CMA Valley score, CMA scored two more times.
Wow.
It's now 29-14. And they still got 2.5 minutes left before halftime.
Holland to Hadashell, left side. Hadashell falls ahead to the 40. Giving five. It'll be second down and five. Those guys up front blowing up big holes for the Rochester offense.
Pat Kays and Braxton Lee are having phenomenal games on the line. I think I'm going to count this half how many times Coach Sainer runs the ball to the left side because they are just blowing up those defensive linemen.
They're doing a great job up front. Are all the guys, Schaefer as well.
Absolutely. Schaefer the center, Calvert, Joe Howard. There's so much space out there in those linemen that Coach Zahner doesn't care where he runs the ball, actually.
Hadashell offset to the right. Here's a pitch to Streeton. Goes left, cuts back into the middle of the field. It gets across the 40 down to around the 42. That's going to bring up third down at about 3 for the Rochester Zebras. Clock rolls here with 11 minutes to play in the third quarter. Rochester leading 16-7 here at Rochester High School over the number 3 team in the state in Class 3A and the Eastbrook Panthers.
I'm guessing right now a lot of the Eastbrook fans and players are hoping that Singler's not serious and he'll be able to recover here in the next week or two and rejoin the team.
Third down and 3 for Rochester at their own 42. Holland under center takes the snap. Gives to Hadashell, stacked up at the line of scrimmage, and maybe a yard. He loses the football, but the ball of the ground is going to cause the fumble.
Yep.
It'll be fourth down and about 2 for the Rochester Zebras, shy of their own 45-yard line, so more than likely a punting situation for Patrick Hayes.
Like you guys said earlier, some of these coaches say that these first two games are just preseason still. They're just practicing for the conference, and I'm sure coaches want Singler back for week 3.
Fourth down and 2 for the Zebras at their own 43-yard line. And Patrick Hayes back to kick the ball away. Last time he kicked was on his goal line. So right back deep to receive the kick.
Wow.
A high snap goes over the head of Patrick Hayes. He boots it, picking it up. Now he's picked it up again, shovels it forward. It is going to be probably an incomplete pass. It should be. And the ball is picked up and ran in for a touchdown for Eastbrook. That's a forward pass. There.
He's marking it off. He's saying
Patrick,
no.
Patrick Hayes shoveled the ball forward. It was a forward pass, but... So it is not a touchdown for Eastbrook, but they're going to take you over in pretty good field position.
And that's pretty bad snap when you think about the 6'5" Ks, and that was off the top of his head.
So if he If he threw the ball forward and there's not a flag for illegal man downfield, which I don't know how there wouldn't be.
Should be up here at the line of scrimmage.
It should be a first down and 10 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 43.
And that's where they're marking the ball.
Yep.
So rather than lose 45 yards on the over-the-head snap, we're going to get it back.
How did that happen?
Somehow the Zebras lucked out there.
Again.
Unreal. Panthers thought they had a touchdown, and now they're back at the 43-yard line.
First and 10 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 43. Wright brings the club to the line of scrimmage. Moore, the flanker to the left side. Martin, the slot man to the right side. Burton behind Wright. Here's a snap. Burton right up the middle, wrapped up by Basham at about the 41. 41. Give him a yard. It'll be second down and 9. Give him 2, I beg your pardon. It'll be second and 8.
Great job by Basham, just sitting right there at the line of scrimmage waiting on him.
Quickly, Eastbrook to the line of scrimmage. Right up and down the line of scrimmage, letting the guys know the play. Wilson wide to the near side, everybody else in tight. Moore goes in motion to the far side. Burton again, right side. Got some running room. He's got a lot of blocks up front, and he is tackled at the Rochester 35. That's going to bring up third down and short for the Eastbrook Panthers with 9:10 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 16-7, but Eastbrook looking at third down and 2 from Rochester's 34. Right again, Burton again, right side, another big hole, and he's off to the races. He pops it outside, pops it back inside, and he is tackled, but not until he gets inside the Rochester 20-yard line.
Yeah, it's 2 plays in a row. Eastbrook has ran to that right side, and those, I can see why. Their lineman over there is 6'3", 230, and 6'1", 220.
17-yard gain for Burton.
First down and 10 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 20-yard line, and it's all been Burton on this drive, which started on Rochester's 43. Ball on the far hash. Burton ready. Plenty of time on the play clock. 15. Burton takes a snap. Burton again, left side, make that right, took the snap and gives to Burton, who falls across the 20, maybe to the 19. Not a lot there. It'll be second down and about 9 for the Eastbrook Panthers.
Freshman Connor McLaughlin got in on that play real quick.
8:28 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 16-7. Eastbrook knocking on the doors. They're inside the red zone at the 19 of Rochester. Right. Ready. Down to 15 on the play clock. Under center. Moore goes in motion right. Burton again, right side. Make that Campbell off the right side. He is stacked up after about a 1 or 2 yard gain. And it'll be third down and about 5 for Eastbrook. This has been a dose of the fullbacks.
Well, and you got to wonder if Eastbrook hasn't gone to their more simpler playbook, the one that's only about half as thick as the regular one.
Third and 5, quickly again. Campbell stacked up in the backfield by McClain and brought down for a loss.
Travis McClain got back there real quick, and Campbell didn't stand a chance when he saw McClain back there. Yeah, back to that playbook. I don't think the quarterbacks ran very often. He's been handing it off and throwing it.
Yeah,
takes away so many plays for Panthers.
Third down and a long 6 for Eastbrook. Moore goes in motion right. Right looking to draw the Zebras offside. Plenty of time on the play clock, down to 14. He looks at the sideline now. Has a new play. Relays it to the line of scrimmage with 9. With 7. Plenty of time still for Eastbrook with 5. Fourth down and 4. On the pass, back to passes right, looks left, steps up, looking for the back of the end zone, has a receiver, it is incomplete. Great job by Hattershell, making up a lot of ground as that pass was up there a long time. They had a wide open receiver in the back of the end zone in Tyler Bennett, and Hattershell made up some ground and knocked the ball away. It'll be first and 10 for the Z's.
Yeah, really good job by Hattershell to recognize all he had to do is knock it down because they right did. He just hung that ball up there. It took about 4 seconds to get to the end zone. Hattershell, good job. The senior recognized all you got to do is just knock it down.
So Rochester takes over at their own 16-yard line, up 16-7 with 7 minutes to play in the third quarter. Bennett comes wide to the near side for Rochester. Flanker right is Hattershell. Cy Holland under center. Ball in the far hash. Rochester going to our right. Heckathorn gets the carry coming to the near side. Has a block. Cuts it inside the block. Kicks it out back outside. And gets out to close to the 20. Maybe 4 on the carry. It'll be second down and about 6 for the Zebras.
News on senior star Jacob Singer. You can look over on the sideline and actually see him in a sling now.
Yeah.
So the ice is done. Sling's on. You can sure count him out for the rest of the game.
And his left arm is in the sling.
Yes.
He's a right-handed quarterback.
Yes.
Ball at the 19-yard line, so giving three. It'll be second down and seven for the Zebras. 6.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Garrick wide to the near side. Kennedy tight right. Hadeshell offset to the left side. Hadeshell gets the carry going left. Spins away from one tackler, but can't get away from all of them. And I believe he lost yards. And from that mark across the way, it looks like he lost about two. It'll bring up third down and nine with under 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester leading 16-7. So Cy Holland and Garrett comes in from the sideline.
Third and long, deep in your own side of the field. Not a situation you want to be
in. Yeah. Garrick wide to the near side. Bennett split left. Hadeshell dots the eye. Kennedy tight right. Holland under center. Fakes the handoff. Rolls to the near side. Looking in the flat to Garrick. It is complete. It's 25 and ran out of bounds.
It's going to be close.
That's going to be awfully close. And it looks like he's going to be, boy, it's going to be close. The clock rolls. And he's going to be shy of the first down of about a yard. It's going to be fourth down and one.
Needed eight, got seven.
At the Rochester 25-yard line. What do you do here? You need 1 yard, fellas. However, you're only up nine.
Give it to Hadeshell. Tell me who caught that.
Garrick. Alec Garrick.
Senior Alec Garrick. Was his first year playing football.
That's right.
Comes up with a big catch right there for the Zebras. Hopefully they can pound it down for 1 yard and get the first down.
Rochester will go for it. Fourth down and one at their own 25-yard line. With five on the play clock. Cy Holland under center. Four on the play clock. Three on the play clock, and they'll use a timeout.
Just trying to draw them off sides. It didn't work.
Zebras will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Football. WROI, Rochester, Indiana.
And we're all about pets.
If you've never visited All About Pets downtown Rochester, why not give them a try? Because they really are all about pets. They're dedicated to bringing the area the finest in pet foods and treats, pet toys, pet health care supplies, an entire room of fish and aquarium supplies, small animal food, pet accessories, just about anything and everything you need for your pet right here locally. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street, Rochester. Locally owned and operated to enhance the happy of your pet. If your pet is looking a little shaggy, call 223-8444 473 and inquire about their grooming service for pets.
And we're all about pets.
This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
As we're away, Rochester comes out with their punting unit. Eastbrook comes on with their punt return team. However, they had 12 men on the field, and a penalty on Eastbrook gives Rochester Zebras 5 yards and a first down. So it'll be first down and 10 for the Z's at their own 30. Straight and right up the middle. Falls across the 30, maybe to the 30, maybe to the 31. Not a lot there. It'll be second down for Rochester.
I can see them just grinding this for the next 50 yards if they can get away with it.
4.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Give Screeton 2 yards. It'll be second down and eight. Ball at the Rochester 32.
They've had the ball for 2.5 minutes on their sixth play, so just keep grinding it out. Couple yards here and there.
That was a huge penalty.
That absolutely was, yeah.
Heckathorn, wide to the near side, short side of the field. Bennett goes split left. Hadeshell offset to the left side. Kennedy tight right for Holland. Here's the snap. Gives to Screeton.
Ooh.
And Screeton has stood up hard at the line of scrimmage. I believe that was Screeton. Indeed. Not a lot there. It'll be third down and eight for Rochester. Clock continues to roll with 3:50 to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 16-7. We got some scores to pass along to you that is getting a little bit surprising to me.
I have one right here. Triton is beating Caston 28-0.
There's one of them.
CMA over Valley 30-14.
There's another one.
Yeah.
Third down and eight. Bennett wide to the near side, short side of the field. Garrick split left, split backs for Cy Holland. Back to passes Holland. Three-step drop. Lobs it up. Bennett, and he's got it complete. Bennett brings it down at about the 47-yard line, and the Zebra first down.
That's what I was talking about with the Zebras having tall receivers over the Panther back. Cy just stepped back, lobbed one up to Bennett, and let him go up and get it.
That was about a two-step drop and all air to Gavin Bennett.
That was a great job by Bennett to get up and catch that over the helmet of the defender.
He has a good 3 or 4 inches on those backs.
A 12-yard pitch and catch from Holland to Bennett, and the Zebras with a fresh set of downs, leading 16-7 with 3:05 to play in the third quarter. Rochester will go to straight T backfield with two tight ends. From their 47, Cy Holland under center of the snap. Gives to Hadashell. Hadashell down the near sideline to the 45, the 40, and then drug out of bounds at about the 39, up, giving the 40, but it'll be first down for the Rochester Zebras.
Hadashell got a big block on the right side by senior Joe Howard.
Good 13-yard pickup by Hadashell again, getting out to the sideline and using his speed.
First down and 10. At the Eastbrook 40-yard line with 2:50 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 16-7. They'll go to the straight T backfield again. Bennett tight left. Kennedy tight right. Ball in the near hash. Hadashell under center. Bobbles a snap. Gives to Heckathorn. He bobbles the handoff and falls ahead for maybe one. It'll be second down and 9.
Rochester lucky to keep possession.
Yeah.
Senior Matt Basham is on the sideline again. The trainer is with him. I think this is his fourth or fifth cramp of the night already.
So second down and 9 for Rochester. Now at the Eastbrook 39-yard line. Again, the Zebras going to our right, up by 9 with 2.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Brad Thomas, Travis Watchering, I'm David Musselman. Jay Heckathorn brings the play in from the sideline. The Zebras break the huddle. And it looks like they'll send Bennett wide to the left side with 6 in the play clock. Quickly, Holland under center with 4, with 3, with 2. Heckathorn gets the handoff coming to the near side. Heckathorn gets a great block by Hadashell, and Heckathorn is stacked up after about a yard gain. It'll bring up third down and near 8 with 2 minutes to play in the third.
Zebras continue to hog the ball. They're on their 10th play of this drive and have the ball for over 6 minutes already.
Yeah, that's good. But they're looking at third down and long right now. At the ball is resting at the Eastbrook 38-yard line on the near hash. Garrett goes split left, wide side of the field. Bennett comes split to the right side. Shotgun formation now for Cy Holland. Hadashell to his right, screen to his left. Kennedy tight left. Here's a snap. High snap to the hands of Holland. He picks it up. Now the ball still loose.
He lost it.
Looks like Rochester's going to fall on it, but they're going to lose 10 yards as they fall on it back at Eastbrook's 49. That is a hard snap, and Streeton, who recovered the fumble, is in pain in the bottom of that pile.
I think it's only the first or maybe second shotgun we've seen all night, and
yeah.
Schaefer just launched that one a little over Cy's head.
Well, I don't know if it was a bad snap, but it was a bullet.
It went
right through his hand.
It was going hard.
Almost as if Holland didn't expect it on one. He was waiting for two.
Yeah. So that'll bring up fourth down and
a lot. Like 18,
fourth about 18. Fourth down and 18 or 19 yards, and Patrick Hayes on again to kick. Wins it and right back deep for Eastbrook. 35 seconds to play, third quarter, and good snap. Good punt.
Great.
Nice high kick. Taken at the 20-yard line by Winget. Winget fakes the handoff. He goes to the right side. Winget down the right sideline. Cuts it back inside. He stood up by Brett Abbott, who basically made a touchdown-saving shoulder block. Didn't tackle him, but he did stand him up long enough for the Zebras to help.
The Panthers had two big kick returns. They both come from that fake reverse. Zebras are falling for it, and it gives Winget the whole right side to attack the field.
So Eastbrook starts to their own 42-yard line with 23 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 16-7. Quickly right on the ball. Wilson wide to the near side. Slot left is Moore. Slot right is Martin. He comes in motion to the near side. He gets the carry coming left. Martin at the 45 cuts it upfield. Now to Rochester territory and driven hard out of bounds by Hadashell at the Rochester 49-yard line. And enough for a Rochester first down. I'm sorry, an Eastbrook first down. with 15.7 to play in the third, and Rochester up 16-7.
Mequonequa still leads North Miami 48-0 at the end of the third quarter.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Big blowout there.
Wilson split left. Ball in on the near hash in Rochester territory. Right, gives to third. He is stacked up and hit hard in the backfield.
Taylor Pugh was not having any of that. As soon as they said hi, Pugh's in the backfield and brought him down hard.
Somebody forgot to block 76.
You don't want to do that.
That's probably exactly what Burke just did.
Well, he's going off the sideline.
That's going to bring the third quarter to a close. Rochester is up 16-7. We're going to the fourth. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Football, WROIFM.com.
And final quarter we go in Rochester High School. The Zebras clinging to a 16-7 lead. And both Eastbrook, Brad, and Rochester exchanged blows in that third quarter. No harm done.
No, you're right. Same score. Moved the ball from 20 to 20, and both defenses giving up some yards, but still looking impressive.
Eastbrook looking at third down and two at basically midfield. And Wright brings a club to the line of scrimmage. Campbell is your fullback as Burton limps off the field after a big hit. Campbell gets the carry, stacked up in the backfield, second effort. Gets him close to the first down marker. I think he's going to be stopped shy. It'll be fourth and one. Now Rochester's 49-yard line.
That was a great double team by Case. He wrapped him up with the legs, and Taylor Pugh came down to finish the job.
Now Campbell doesn't have quite the same speed that Burton's got, but he's a big boy, hard to bring down.
Oh, it's going to be close enough for a measurement. But Travis, you're right. Campbell, he's a big kid. You know, Campbell comes in the game at 5'9", 205 pounds. He was hit in the backfield by just one Zebra. Mm-hmm. That's not going to do it.
You're right.
Great job, though, for Kays over holding on to him and letting the rest of the Zebras come and take him down.
As they stretch the chains, they are going to be short of about a half a yard. So it'll be fourth and about a foot and a half.
Not the length of the football.
Yeah, you're right. For Eastbrook at the Rochester 49-yard line, I wouldn't give it anybody else but 34 for Eastbrook if I was Coach Adamson, which I'm not. But
unless Burton sneaks back in.
I don't know. I think he's probably standing over there with Singer.
big stop for Coach Zaner Zebras right here.
Fourth and less than a yard for Eastbrook at Rochester's 49-yard line. Ball in the middle of the field. Campbell is your fullback. Wright looks at the official. Under center now. Takes the snap. Gives to Campbell right side. Campbell has the first down and more. Campbell lowers his shoulder and falls across the 40 down to around the 37-yard line. First and 10 for Eastbrook.
Great job by Campbell. He got past that initial line of scrimmage and boom, 5 yards in about three steps.
The Zebras are crowded in the middle of the ball, and Campbell just snuck around to the left side to get the first down and some.
Give him the 38. It'll be first and 10 for Eastbrook. Campbell still the fullback in the backfield for the Panthers. First and 10 at Rochester's 38. Campbell again gets the carry. Stood up in the backfield. This is a fumble, but Eastbrook falls on it. Campbell fumbles it and then regains the ball as he gets it back at the 40. So he's going to lose two. It's going to be second down and 12. Nice job by Cy Holland. And also Wilson Lee for ripping that ball away from Campbell. Second down and 12 at Rochester's 40 for the Panthers. 11 minutes to play in the game. Rochester up 16-7. Back to pass is right. Throws left. He's got an open receiver. Wilson popped up. Oh! Great defensive play over there by Caskey, who gave up about 6 inches.
Yeah.
Ball popped up in the air, and Jacob Hadashell came over there, had both hands on it from the interception, and dropped it.
Fantastic job by Kyle Caskey at 5'7 and 138 pounds, going against the 6'5 6'1", 175-pound receiver. He popped the ball straight up in the air. Perfect timing on the defense.
Third down and 12 for East Booker. Rochester's 40-yard line going to our right are the Panthers. Gives the play, Martin going left. Got a wall of blockers in front of him. Martin with a head of steam is cut down shy of the first down, and I believe cut down shy of the 30, but it's going to be a lot manageable as the clock rolls with 10:40 to play in the game. It's going to be fourth down for Eastbrook at Rochester's 31-yard line. Fourth down in about three.
And they're going for it.
Quickly on the ball are the Panthers. Ball on the far side of the field. Wilson under center, fourth down and a long two. Burton left side, big first down, and he's tackled him at the 21. A huge first down for Burton and of about 10 yards. And quickly, Eastbrook back on the ball. First and 10 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 21, knocking on the door again of the Panthers. Right, again, Burton again, left side. Left this time, not a whole lot there, maybe to the 20. It'll be second down in about 9 or 10 minutes of play in the game. Rochester up 16-7, and Burton comes up limping. He leaves the game limping on his right foot. But Campbell comes back in, who is a bigger load than Burton.
Yeah, but Burton, wow, comes in, gets the ball two carries in a row for 12 yards and really put a little spark in that offense for Eastbrook.
Second and long for Eastbrook at Rochester's 19-yard line. Right, gives some more, coming to the near side with blockers in front of him. Right, cuts it upfield, and we got a flag on the play. We're going to have a blocking on the near side. I'm sorry, we're going to have a holding on the near side. As Moore gets out to the Rochester 15-yard line, but I believe there's going to be a hold here on the near side.
We got Jay Heckathorn down on the sideline with looks like an ankle. Rolled up, got somebody rolled up on his ankle.
So it will be a hold on Eastbrook. And that hold comes back at about the 22. Winnemack now up 42-0 in the third quarter. They are playing in Knox this evening. 9:38 to play in the football game here at Rochester. The Zebras leading 16-7.
Push Eastbrook back to the 30-yard line.
It'll be second down. And what is that, about 18 yards or so, 20 yards?
18 yards anyway, yeah. It looks like a cramp on the sideline there for Heckathorn, not an ankle, which is good.
Second down and 19 or 20 for Eastbrook back at the Rochester 30-yard line. Ball in the near hash. Wilson, the only lone wideout. He's wide to the near side. Campbell is your fullback. Slot man to the right is Moore. Slot back to the left is Winget. Right under center. Moore goes in motion to the far side. Fake handoff. Here comes the pressure. Wright steps up. He's got a receiver down the field. It is incomplete. Intended for a Winget. Kasky again.
Yep,
a great play
by Kasky. He gives up a lot of hype. But boy, he can get off the ground. He about had himself an interception there at about the 5-yard line.
The 5'8", 155-pound Kyle Kasky has come up with two big plays this series, knocking the ball down.
Third down and 20 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 30.
Good news for the Warriors. They put up their first touchdown of the night.
Now we're going to three wideouts. Two to the left for Eastbrook. One to the near side. Campbell is your lone back in the backfield. Slot man to the left is Winget. Right into center on third and 20. Right, back to pass. Three-step drop. Here comes the pressure over the middle. It is complete to Zoda. And Zoda gets close to the first down and takes a shot.
That was a wide open Zoda.
Yeah.
Yep, it was. He was wide open and hit him right in stride for about an 18-yard gain and a first down.
Yep, give him enough for a first down. It'll be first and 10 for Eastbrook at about the 11-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. A huge third down conversion for Wright and the Eastbrook Panthers.
15 play of the drive. We've had the ball for 5.5 minutes.
9:15 to play in the game. Rochester up 16-7. Campbell gets the carry left, cuts back right in the middle of the field now. Bear crawls up to the 4. A gain of 7 yards. It'll be second down and about, it must be second and goal. Must have been inside the 10, maybe the 9. Second and goal from the 4 for Eastbrook. Right quickly under center. Gives a right again. Makes that Campbell again going left, and he is in the backfield.
No gain.
He's brought down by junior Jacob Hadishell real quick.
Third and goal. Back at the 5, 8.5 minutes to play in the game. Rochester clinging to a 16-7 lead. Coming back into the game is Martin. Wright brings the play in from the sideline. Moore goes out of the game for Eastbrook. Down to 22 on the play clock. Eastbrook with plenty of time.
They continue to run the ball to that left side behind sophomore Nathan James, the 6'1", 220 pounds.
Yeah.
And then Eric Mason, the senior, the 6'3", 230 pounds.
Eastbrook finally huddles. They break the huddle, come to the line of scrimmage with 7. And now Coach Adamson will try to use a timeout, and he will. Eastbrook will take a timeout. We'll take a 60-second break. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's tables since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
RTC, your locally owned telecommunications provider, is here to make your communications world easier so you have more time to do what you like enjoying sports. At RTC, they're proud to bring you RTC Telephone, Fiber Connect high-speed internet, and cable television in digital and high def. For information, call 574-223-2191. Be sure and watch Channel 4, your only local access channel for Zebra football action from Friday night's game. Broadcast time, 10 a.m. Saturday morning. RTC, local products, local support, local investment.
This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. Third and goal from the 5 for Eastbrook. After their timeout, they go to a wishbone look. The carry goes to Martin. Martin left side, stacked up and going nowhere. Actually,
he drove it all the way to the ground, and he got pretty close to the goal line.
He was hit at the line of scrimmage in second or third effort, I beg your pardon, got him close to the goal. It'll be fourth and goal at the, inside the one. It looks like right at the goal line.
Couple local blowouts real quick. Winnemac is up 49-0 over Culver, and Peru is up 40-0 to Wabash.
Wishbone look again, fourth and goal from the goal line. Here comes the carry to Martin, looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Eastbrook.
Untouched for Martin. A one-yard touchdown run for Eastbrook makes it 16-13 in favor of Rochester with the extra point coming up.
Kyle Martin and one-yard touchdown run for Eastbrook with 7:28 to play in the fourth quarter. Like Brad said, cuts the lead to 16-13 with the two-point conversion coming the way it looks from the Eastbrook Panthers. Wishbone look again for the Eastbrook Panthers. Two tight end, one to each side. Right under center. Gives to Martin going left. Dodges one tackler, but not bash him, and that's going to do it. Two-point conversion, no good. Rochester leading 16-13, 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
You can actually trade in your current car for a new Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram and get the same or even lower payments.
You heard right. Mike Anderson Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram is hosting a trade-up sales event where
you can trade in your current car for a new Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram and get the same or lower payments.
Unbelievable, but it's true. Stop by Mike Anderson until Labor Day, and we'll show you how we've helped hundreds of satisfied customers trade in their current vehicles for a brand new vehicle
with the same payment or less.
Plus, with end of summer back to school specials, we have even more ways to lower your payment. With so much to offer and so much to save, you can't afford to miss this event. Instead of just trading in, trade up at the summer clearance event at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, 1702 Main Street in Rochester. Visit MikeAndersonCDJ.com for more details.
Football, 92.1 WROI.
7:28 to play in the football game. Rochester up 16-13. That scoring drive coming by Kyle Martin with a one-yard run. 7:28 to play in the game. The two-point conversion failed. 16-13 Rochester.
They had the ball for 7 minutes for a total of 16 plays. Like you said, it was a 58 yards down the field, but ended with a one-yard Martin touchdown.
Well, the Zebras have had two long, sustained drives for scores tonight. They need one more if they want to ice it.
Long, sustained drive. They don't have to score. Just keep it for 7.5 minutes.
Exactly.
Elliott, the kick. High end over end kick, short. Heckathorn takes it at about the 17. Heckathorn right up the middle. Heckathorn to the 35 and his tackle. No,
he's still going.
Heckathorn stays with his feet across the infield at the 45. Inside the 45 to the 41. What a fantastic run back by Jay Heckathorn. I thought he was stopped at about the 40-yard line. Second and third effort got him out to the Eastbrook 42.
50 yards on that return by Jay Heckathorn, and he was dropped after about the 30-yard line and managed to put his hand down, keep his feet under him, and keep on going.
First and 10 for Rochester at the Eastbrook 42-yard line. Z's going to our left. Kennedy tight to the right. Bennett tight to the left. Flanker to the right side is Garrick. Eye back formation for Holland. First and 10. Garrick comes in motion to the near side. Here's the snap. Hand off to Houdeshell right side. Jacob Houdeshell lowers his head, pushes the pile forward, wow, and takes Eastbrook down to the 35-yard line to pick up a near 7.
An incredible run by Houdeshell behind his left tackle, Pat Kays, again.
With a linebacker on his hanging on the front of him.
I think he carried that linebacker 5 yards.
Yeah.
Third down, and make that second down and 3 for Rochester. Under 7 minutes to play in the game, leading 16-13.
Houdeshell with 117 yards on 18 carries and 2 touchdowns already tonight.
Good for him. Flanker this time to the right side is Heckathorn. Eye back formation again for the Zebras. Second down and 3 from Eastbrook's 35. Heckathorn comes in motion to the near side. Holland gets the snap. Heckathorn gets it on the end of the round right side. Shakes one tackler. Cuts it back outside. Looking for the sideline. He's still on his feet. Tackled, but not until before he gets to the first down. And he's going to be inside the 30-yard line near the 27. A first down for the Rochester Zebras.
I would love to know how many yards he has after contact. I feel like he gets hit right away, but just keeps going.
He managed to get around that defensive end right there at the line of scrimmage and then pick up 10 yards after he broke free.
First down and 10 for Rochester at the Eastbrook 26-yard line. 6:20 to play in the game. Rochester up 16-13. Ball now in the far hash. Zebras still in the huddle.
Doing just what we said they needed to do, running the ball, running the clock, and keeping the things moving.
They break
the
huddle, with 8 seconds, with 6 seconds. Holland under center quickly. Ibacks behind him with 4. Garrett comes in motion to the near side with 1. Here's the snap. Houdeshell left side, and he is going to be dropped for a loss. Houdeshell pushed back to about the 29, and he's going to lose about 3 yards. It'll bring up second down and 13, but more importantly, clock running with 5:45 to play in the game.
That's only the third run Houdeshell's had all night that he's lost yardage.
He was in a hurry there. Cy was trying to snap that ball for time right now. I think he had 1 second before time to play.
Second down and 13 for Rochester. Ball just inside the 30-yard line of Eastbrook. They'll come to the line of scrimmage with 2 tight ends and I-back formation. And now we're going to have a stoppage of play.
Equipment.
Or blood.
Oh, yeah.
So they're going to have to replace him. And going out of the game is James Reagan. I believe he might have had some blood on his right arm as he comes out. So Rochester going to get a small breather and get ready to go back to business here on third down. Make that second down and 13.
Eric Mason comes in for Eastbrook, senior, 6'3", 230. So they didn't lose much.
Jabal just inside the Eastbrook 30-yard line. Cy Holland showing he's a veteran quarterback, standing straight up, looking at the play clock. It's down to 10, down to 8, down to 7, down to 6, down to 5, now under center, the 3. Here's the snap. On the end of round, Heckathorn takes it. Jay Heckathorn at the 30, gets back to the line of scrimmage. Rochester lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage, lucky to hang on to the football.
Yeah, that was kind of a bobbled snap there between Holland and Heckathorn, but Heckathorn did a good job of just muscling his way around the corner and trying to get something out of nothing.
Third down and 13, the ball at the 29-yard line, 4:35 to play in the game. Rochester up 16-13. Ball in the near hash.
Boy, third and 13, you hate to have to throw the ball.
Yeah, you're right.
Especially when you're in your opponent's 29-yard line. But, you know, if you can get a first down out of it, it's worth it.
High back formation for Cy Holland and company. Down to 8 seconds. Cy now under center with 5. Takes the snap. Here's the pitch to Houdeshell going right. Has a blocker. Cuts it back into the middle of the field. Jacob Houdeshell spun down close to the 20-yard line. It's going to be fourth and manageable if Coach Zander decides to go that route.
He's going to pick up 8 yards on that run.
It'll be fourth and 5 for Rochester at the Eastbrook. Well, just shy of the 20. It's going to be about the 21, maybe. 22. 3:45 to play in the football game. Cy Holland brings the play in from the sideline. Down to 10 on the play clock. They're going to have to hurry.
They've run 4 minutes off this clock since Eastbrook's score, so that's pretty good.
Fourth and five at Eastbrook's 22. We're down to 3 on the play clock, to 2-1, and now Rochester will use a timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Get smooth one-coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one-coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Enyard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
The next time you buy a cart full of groceries, make a car payment, or write that big mortgage check, ask yourself, what would my family do if I wasn't there to buy those groceries, or make that car payment, or write that check? If you didn't like the answer, ask a State Farm agent about life insurance and start getting some answers you will like. Welcome to that place where doing it for them meets doing it today. Get started by contacting State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3011.
WROI. 3 minutes and 30 seconds to play in the football game here at Rochester High School. The Z's leading 13 to make that 16-13. And after their timeout, they'll be looking at fourth down and five from Eastbrook's 22-yard line.
You know, I just noticed this, and you're probably going to say they did this last year, but Rochester's got a big old script R on the side of the helmets.
Yeah, that wasn't like that. Honestly.
Yeah, that's the first I remember anything being on the side of a Rochester helmet.
Bennett wide to the near side. A lone back is Streeton. Two slots or two flankers for Rochester. Holland under center. Fourth and five for Rochester at the 22 of Eastbrook. Heckethor comes in motion on the near side. Gets the pitch coming left. Cuts it upfield. Looking for the first.
Fumbles.
And it fumbles it. And then it's picked up by Eastbrook.
He'd have been short of the first down anyway. But the fumble goes to Eastbrook.
Eastbrook's defender who recovered the football was laying on the ground, and basically the ball rolled right into the breadbasket. First down and 10 for Eastbrook at their own 22-yard line with 3 minutes, 23 seconds to play in the football game. Rochester up by 3. Eastbrook has 2 timeouts.
Do they have a field goal kicker?
Not anymore.
Well, that's right. It was Singer, wasn't it?
Yeah.
He did it all.
Singer, Jacob Singer, the All-State candidate for Eastbrook, was hurt on play number 2 of the game. And is over with his arm in the left sling, or his left arm in a sling, right under center. From his 22, takes the snap on the double reverse, gives to Wingett. Wingett left side, Wingett picking his way through traffic. There's a flag in the play. Wingett takes it over, takes it out to the 32-yard line. He'll pick up 10, but...
Yeah, probably going to have holding. It's in the backfield.
It is.
So that's going to be a big penalty on Eastbrook.
3 minutes, 15 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 16-13. And we've got a Wingett slow to get up. The trainer comes out, which means he'll have to come out of the game, and Martin will come in for him.
Wow. That's three of them for Eastbrook that's gone down tonight.
And he's limping on his right foot. Sorry.
That was holding for Eastbrook. That is their fifth penalty now for 40 yards.
Okay. A couple of score updates.
We have a couple of teams in the TRC getting beat right now. 28-7, Wallace C over Whitco, and 48-12, Mequonacaw still over North Miami.
No update from CMA. CMA still leads 30-14.
Your informant might have went home. So it'll be first down and 20. Well, a long way back at the 12-yard line for Eastbrook. West Central defeats Colburn tonight 18-6. Their first win of the season. Right under center on first and 20, back in his own 12. Martin gets the carry going left. Martin on the jet sweep going left and is cut down from behind by, I believe, Basham and Hadashell.
Hadashell just leveled him.
Basham gets up slow again, cramping. And we're another Eastbrook Panther on the ground over there. He's hurt, slow to get up.
Go ahead. Streeton coming in the game for cramped Basham again.
2 minutes, 55 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 16-13.
Shy of maybe the 19 they can call it.
And the ball is going to be at around the 19-yard line.
The North Miami game, Quantico game, is called as a 48-12 final. Quantico over North Miami.
Wow.
Rough start.
Second down and 14 for Eastbrook. They'll send twins on the near side. They'll send one receiver left, right under center, with Burton behind him. Clock rolls. Back to pass is right. Looking to the middle of the field. Has his man. It's Zoda. It is complete. And Zoda comes down with it at the 42-yard line. Enough for an Eastbrook first down. That's the second time they went to Zoda on the exact same pass route.
And the second time Zoda's been wide open on the exact same pass route.
Yep, 23-yard gain and a first down for Eastbrook.
First down and 10 for Eastbrook with 2.5 minutes to play in the game. They'll send one receiver to the near side, two to the left will Eastbrook. Burton is the lone back in the backfield. Slot to the left side is Moore. Under center now is Wright. Right back to pass. Three-step drop. Looking left. Throwing left. It is incomplete. That pass intended on the far side, and believe Moore. And Screeton just about had a pick. It'll be second down and 10. Clock stopped with 2:22 to play in the game.
Another completed game just came through. Winnemac over Knox 56-0.
Second down and 10 for Eastbrook at their own 43-yard line. The Panthers going to our right. They'll send one wide out wide to the near side. They'll go back to the traditional formation we've seen all night tonight. Two slots and a fullback. Right under center on second down and 10. Motion man goes left. Burton has it. Goes left side. He is stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there. Third and 10. McLean there. Also Kays there. Also Connor McLaughlin was there. Yeah, give him one. Third down and 10. Third down and 9. 1:59 to play in the game. Back under center is Wright. Back to pass. Steps up. Got a little pressure. Now kicks into the outside left. Down the field. He's got a first down and is tackled shy of the Rochester 35. Another huge first down for Eastbrook.
Huge run by Wright. There wasn't anything open downfield. He just tucked it and run.
Yeah, you got that right. He had a miscommunication on a pass route, and then he saw the open field and took advantage of it. Got a lot of yards.
Actually give Wright the 35-yard line. 1:45 to play in the game. Eastbrook has the football at the Rochester 35, down by 3. Wright, back to pass, three-step drop. Now steps up, got a lane to run in. Now shakes one tackler and is brought down shy of the 30, giving the 31 a pickup of 4. Clock rolls, 90 seconds to play in the game.
It almost looks like that might have been a quarterback draw. I think he's shotgun in. He's not even looking at his receivers.
Wright is slow to get up. They stop the clock for Wright. He's got to come out of the game.
You're right. Yeah, absolutely. And it looks like he's reaching for his front foot, like he's cramping.
New Prairie leads LaPorte at halftime, 27-0.
Of course, he just picked up 30 yards on two carries, so.
Lewis Caspi, Pioneer, 29-0.
It'll be second down and 5. Second down and 6, I beg your pardon, at Rochester's 31-yard line for Eastbrook with 1:27 to play in the game. Rochester up 16-13. And so Wright's got to come out for a play. Who will be the new quarterback?
Our third string.
Is it going to be Moore? Looks like Moore standing right in the middle of that huddle. Will he take the snaps?
Wildcat formation, maybe.
So Eastbrook breaks the huddle. Down to 16 on the play clock. Nope,
number 7.
Yep. Tyler Bennett will be the quarterback for Eastbrook on second down and 6. Here's a snap. Gives to Moore coming around the near side. Moore cuts it inside. Moore cuts it back outside and is brought down about the 26-yard line. He's going to be close to another Eastbrook first down with 1 minute to play in the game. Clock rolls. Well, they're not even going to measure. Boy, that was close. It's going to be third down and 1 with 50 seconds to play in the game. Third and 1 with 50 seconds to play in the game.
Good job by the Rochester defense keeping him in bounds.
Right back under center. Two right outs to the left, one to the near side for Eastbrook. Third and 1. Right, back to pass. Three-step drop. Looks left. Throws in the middle of the field. Complete to Zoda. Zoda shakes a tackler. Shakes another tackler. Gets it inside the Rochester 5. First and goal for Eastbrook, and now we're going to have a late flag penalty.
Late hit by Rochester.
And if that's going to be on Rochester, it'll be half the distance, which will give him about the 2.5-yard line with 30 seconds to play in the game.
I don't know what play they keep running to Zoda, but that's the third time he's been wide open.
Screen is calling personal foul on Eastbrook, and so is Heckathorn.
Wow.
Eastbrook shooting back. Maybe it was on them. And it was.
Wow. Personal foul on Eastbrook after the play. So that's going to take him from the 5 back to the 20-yard line with 30 seconds to play in the game.
Huge penalty.
I think somebody might want to guard 8.
Absolutely.
That's Zota, by the way.
So instead of a 23-yard gain, they get an 8-yard gain.
Well, they're going to get the gain after the play. It's a dead ball. And so Eastbrook will want to talk about it. We're going to take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
Jim Downs, your local Culligan man, has asked me to talk to you about your drinking water. If you want the great taste of bottled water without the hassle of going to the store to get it, call Jim about Culligan Bottled Water Delivery. It's always fresh, delicious, and delivered to your home. 574-223-2420 or go to CulliganFultonCounty.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
This is Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI.
30 seconds to play in the football game. Rochester clinging to a 16-13 lead. Eastbrook has just used another timeout, which means they're down to 1. They have it first and 10 at the Rochester 20-yard line.
So after a 23-yard gain by Eastbrook that took them to the 5, the personal foul penalty brings it back to the 20, and the result of the play is still a first down.
Here's what I would do again.
Throw it to Zota.
I throw it to Zota.
He's got 3 receptions for 63 yards.
Tyler Bennett is streaking to the locker room for Eastbrook.
Huh. Interesting.
I would throw it to Zota again. He lines up wide on the near side, wide side of the field. Right under center. First and 10 for Eastbrook at Rochester's 20. 30 seconds of play in the game. Rochester up by 3. Back to pass is right. Here comes the pressure. Throws down the middle of the field. He is looking for Wingett. It is incomplete. Nice job by Cy Holland on the coverage. He just batted the ball away. It'll be second down and 10 with 23.8 to play in the game.
You know, Zota was going down the field with his hand in the air. I think he might have missed another wide open Zota.
Could have been. You don't suppose Bennett's running in to get Singer's shoulder pad so he can kick a field goal.
You know what? That's exactly what's happening. They're
going to have to burn a timeout. Here he comes back, but I don't see any.
There's no pads with him. He's just right there.
That's exactly what they're doing.
They're going to try and get Singer in the game to kick the field goal.
Back to pass is right. Here comes the pressure. Now rolls to the right, looking for some group throw. Throws it up for grabs. It is incomplete.
At the goal line. Again, Cy Holland on the play.
It'll be third down and 10 with 15.7 to play in the game.
So Eastbrook is frantically trying to get a uniform and shoulder pads to put on Singer to put him
kick.
In this game to kick the game-tying
exactly right.
field goal. And right now at the 20, you're looking at a 34, 35-yard field goal.
Oh, he's got plenty of leg, that's for sure. Third down and 10 for Eastbrook with 15.7 to play in the football game. Ball to Rochester 20. Rochester up by 3. Singer directing traffic. 2 wide out to the near side. Soto wide to the right. Right side of the field. Right under center. Back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Steps up. Throws down the middle of the field. He's got a receiver. It is.
Oh, man, 10. Almost intercepted by Katsky.
That's a great, great, great job by Katsky right there. 5'9 Katsky blocking the ball down from 6'1 Zota.
Well, Zota just turned the wrong way. The ball was thrown behind him. Katsky almost.
You know what? Here comes someone with pads.
Bennett
down.
You're right. Bennett is coming back. Bennett is bringing out Singer's pad.
We got 9 seconds to go in the game, and they're going to get Singer in here
Singer
to kick the field goal.
Unbelievable.
So Singer now is running to the far sideline. Eastbrook will use their final timeout so they can suit up Singer to attempt a game-tying field goal with 9.2 seconds to play in the football game. Like you said, Brad, this will be a 37-yarder
wow.
for the Eastbrook Panthers.
Unbelievable.
They had to gingerly put him in the shoulder pad because his left arm is banged up.
He can't even put his own shoulder pads on.
Yeah.
This is incredible.
Look at him.
He can't hardly get the pads on. He's in so much pain.
More people helping Singer over there get these pads on.
This will be amazing if he can pull this off.
Everybody, including the Rochester coaching staff, looking at the far corner. They're down on Eastbrook's sideline, about the 15-yard line. His pads are on. His helmet is on. He is babying that left arm. He's got the field goal tee in his hand, and he's coming on the field. The ball will be kicked virtually from the middle of the field 37 yards away.
So a 37-yard field goal for Singer, who we have not seen in this game since the second play from scrimmage.
This is something you do not see every Friday night.
9.2 to play in the game. Singer will come back on the field and will attempt a game-tying 37-yard field goal kicking to the east. 16-13 Rochester.
They're not kicking. They're going for it.
They're not kicking.
They're going for it. They're going for the victory.
Fourth down and 10, and now Coach Zander will use a timeout. Well, if and we'll keep it here again. If Coach Addison was using that as a distraction,
it worked. Well, and maybe, you know, once they got that all taken care of, Singer just couldn't go.
You know, because Singer's not in the game on that last play right there.
They were going from, it looked like a shotgun formation there. It's going to be fourth and 10 for Eastbrook. It does not look like Singer's coming on the field.
Wow.
After all that running,
that was a lot of
Tyler
drama.
Bennett.
A lot of drama just to,
that was awesome.
To not try and pull it off. I don't know. Maybe Singer's just in too much pain. Maybe he just can't do it.
This is obviously a non-conference game. This doesn't go very far to.
Well, you're right. If there's a bad snap and he gets plowed.
And he's done for the
he's
year.
He's done for the year, yeah.
So Coach Addison might have, during that timeout, had second thoughts. Yeah.
After the trouble they had just getting the shoulder pads on him, he probably thought maybe better thought better of it.
I had people text me asking what just happened. I said, well, I don't know either. It's confusion out here.
13-16 Rochester. Eastbrook after the Rochester timeout.
No, they're going to go
at the Rochester 20-yard line, down by three, fourth down and 10. Wright is in the shotgun formation for the first time tonight. A wide receiver, two wide outs to the near side, one to the far.
Do or die for the Panthers.
Here's a snap, low snap, back to pass is Wright. Throws it up in the corner of the end zone, looking for Wilson.
Caskey is going to win. Caskey with the interception.
That's only fitting. Caskey's had a great game in the secondary all night, and Rochester's going to hold on and knock off the number three team in the state in Class 3A, the Eastbrook Panthers. They'll take one step down it, and that'll be it.
Absolutely incredible by Kyle Caskey. He's made huge plays the entire night. Congratulations to him for that big interception.
5'7"?
5'9"? Tiny. That's all it is. And that was over Zoda again, I think, the 6'2".
Yeah. No, that was Wilson.
Oh, wasn't
that
Wilson?
Was Wilson
okay.
On the far side.
Either way, great defense by Caskey.
So Rochester will have it first and 10 of their own 20. They will be in the victory formation for Coach Zahner and the Rochester Zebras. Cy Holland, all he has to do is catch it clean from Schaefer and take a knee. He does so. There's the knee, and that'll do it. The Rochester Zebras hold on to defeat the number three team in the state, the Eastbrook Panthers, by the final of 16-13. We'll wrap things up after this on 92.1 WROI.